Hi, welcome to this series about CrowdSim 3D. CrowdSim 3D is a crowd simulation add-on for Blender. With the add-on, you can create crowd simulations for your movies. For example, a stadium full of people, a hurdle of people moving along, and many other cases. The series is broken up in three parts. The first part is about configuring a model and its character and material variations. We will show how to populate your scene with these configurations. The second part will show you various tools for adding agents to your scene. And the last part of the series, we will show how to add logic to your agents. If you have any questions about the add-on, please get in contact with us. But for now, let's continue with the first part, configuring characters. Here we have a model that we want to use in a crowd simulation. The model consists out of an armature and several meshes. Some of these meshes we want to make optional. The idea is to have two characters. One called police with a headlight and one called thief with a mask. The first step is to enable CrowdSim for the model. We do that by selecting the armature and go to the object tab in the property space. Here you will find the CrowdSim panel. We tick the checkbox so we can use this armature in the crowd simulation. After the crowd simulation is activated for the armature, we can now configure the two characters. For the character configuration, we use the node editor. There's a new node tree type called CrowdSim tree. We add a new tree and enable the fake user button. This will make sure that we won't lose this configuration when saving. We add an armature node and name the first output police. We add a mesh node and add default meshes to this node. We are going to use this node to share meshes between the police and thief character. We add a new mesh node and select the meshes that are only relevant for the police character. Using a mesh group node, we connect the two mesh nodes to the police character. For the thief character, we take similar steps. We add a character to the armature node and name it thief. We add the mesh group node. We add the mesh node with only the mask. It is time to test our characters. I add an agent to the scene. In the object panel, I can set the model for the agent. A new panel appears that contains the character options. When I select thief or police, the right meshes are displayed. To make it more interesting, we want the mask to be optional. To do this, we add a new mesh group node and add a without mask and with mask group. We do not connect anything to the without mask group, but connect the thief meshes to the with mask group. By ticking weighted, we configure this group to be your choice. To test the changes, we first refresh our agent. A new option is displayed where we control whether the mask is shown or not. Next to meshes, you can also add variations to materials. We select the armature and go to the object panel. Here we can add a material variable. We name the variable and select the type of variable. This can be a value, a color, or a texture variable. For this variable, we select the color. We can pick several colors. These colors will be the possible options to choose from when using this variable. Now we can link the variable to actual materials. The color variable is able to update RGB nodes in a material. If you want to change the color of another node, we should extract that color to a separate RGB node. Give the RGB node a name so we can find it. We can set the option Use as Diffuse to also update the viewport color. Now let's test the created material variable. We start with refreshing the character. A new panel is displayed with the material variables. When we change these variables, the materials are updated directly. Okay, that's all for the first chapter. In the next chapter, we will go over adding crowds to the scene and populating the agent using automatic selection.